Hello there, guys and girls. Welcome to another quick tip. This time we will talk about a topic that has been requested a lot by my viewers, color grading. Well, and I do have to make a distinction here. We're actually gonna talk about basic color correction. You will learn how to optimize the footage from GTA in your video editing software for more impact. Color grading is an entire science in itself, and there are tons of in-depth tutorials about this on YouTube. It really doesn't matter if you're using real-life footage or in-game footage for this. Also, if you don't have a calibrated grading monitor, it's really hard to achieve universally satisfying results anyway. If you want to get started with color grading, you should definitely use the free plugin DaVinci Resolve for your editing software, as it's beginner-friendly and very potent. Check out Danny Fungus' channel, as he invests a lot of thought into his color grading for Machinima. Now let's dive into the actual topic. I'm gonna show you these techniques using Adobe Premiere Pro. First of all, I recommend you to render your footage with the mod Extended Video Export for better video quality. I've created a tutorial about how to use it a while back. Check it out if you haven't yet. Once you have rendered your footage and imported it into your video editor, it's time to do the color correction. In my opinion, it's best to do all the editing first. That includes audio design, like I've shown you in the previous quick tip. That's because in Premiere you can then use adjustment layers. So instead of applying color correction and video effects to every little bit of footage, you only have to do that step once, and then you can change the length of the effects by clipping or extending this adjustment layer. It's practical if you have a scene change, for instance, because you can make a cut and easily create a different set of adjustments for another scene. The next part is highly opinionated, since this is the way I like to do it. You gotta find your own way based on the advice I'm giving you, since color in movies is very subjective. What I usually do is to go to the effects panel and then put the Lumetri color effect on the adjustment layer. Also, I like to use unsharp mask and grain for this, so I'll drag and drop those onto the same layer too. Then you can switch up into the effects settings and you should see all the effects you just dragged in. Let's start with the quick ones. The footage from GTA usually comes out a bit muddy, even if it has a resolution of full HD and is rendered with Eve. The unsharp mask makes your image look a little more crisp, but you must not overdo it with these values. I usually go for 50 to 75 in strength and increase the radius to 1.5 or 2 maximum. This is enough to give the GTA footage a much more realistic and sharp look. Next up is the grain. Real life film usually has some amount of grain, especially older movies shot on film rolls. But that's a topic in itself again. I just like to apply a very tiny amount of grain to my footage because this extra layer kinda glues all the elements in a shot together, if that makes any sense. It's enough to use an intensity of 3-5%. Uncheck the box to use color grain though. What you want here is monochromatic grain. The effect is super subtle, but it gives the cinematics a more realistic and even grim look if you turn up the value higher. And now let's get to the Lumetri color. Obviously my menu is in German here, but I'll try to name everything correctly. A very interesting slider is white balance and temperature. This will allow you to quickly change the look of a shot. So if you want to do a nighttime shot or something in cold weather, literally turn down the temperature here to make the image more bluish. The same applies for hot weather and the desert. Just turn it up. Even if it's a regular shot, I advise you to make the image a little warmer because the GTA footage tends to be rendered a little bluish by default. The next section is called color and it allows you to adjust the lighting. I like to turn this value up by 0.5 or 1 to brighten things up and make them look a little more polished. You can also increase the contrast by around 50 here because the GTA footage tends to look really flat. Also, I like to play around with the highlights and shadows. Usually I turn the shadows down a little bit to make the shot look richer. Last but not least, there's the saturation slider. If you want to show a happy, bubbly situation, feel free to bump the saturation up a little to make the colors more vivid. A grim cinematic could very well do with a saturation of 85 to 90 to make everything look grayish and sad. As you can see, the Lumetri color panel offers a lot more dials and values to manipulate, but let's just compare what we've achieved so far. I think even by doing so very little, we achieved a massive improvement on the original footage. Kinda like someone who restores old paintings. No, not like that. You know what I mean. Now slap a letterbox on that shit like I've shown you in part 2 of the series and voila, there's a million views waiting for you right there. The most important lesson about color correction and grading is that the type of color adjustments always need to make sense with the scene, the emotions, the message you're showing. The rest is just trial, error and practice. And that's about it for this quick tip. If you have any questions, just hit me up in the comment section. Thank you for watching. whanowa, over.